Hello everyone, let's look at Rye, a hassle-free Python experience. 45 contributors. It was first released in May of 2023. We're now in February 2024. It aims to provide project and package management, but it's got all these features as well. So I'm going to let you look at an article I wrote on my website, Red and Green, which is very, very superficial, but it does include some tips which you won't find on the documentation, which is how to actually add your own main and then your own function. So what Rye does is it builds you this project directory structure, but the example refers to using init.py. So I've just added main, and then in the pyproject.toml, Rye gives you, and it's a way to add loads of config, which gives you ways to configure. You can add an entry point such as this, which is the project's called R1, the file is main, and then the function is greeting. So that differs slightly from what you would see in the standard documentation. There we go, that's kind of the structure. So the pyproject.toml is probably the file you'll edit most. There's a video here which you can click on, which will take you to YouTube, which is made by the creator of this project, which is Armin Ronacher. Without further ado, that's how to install it if you're on Linux or Mac. On Windows, you can download and run the installer. There's a Discord forum, which is quite good. I've observed development of Rye-like tools over the years, Conda, PipX, Flit, they didn't mention poetry. I've simultaneously updated a list of common features. So Rye is the only tool so far that does all of these. So Executor, Bootstraps installs Python versions. Rye lets you choose different Python versions. Then obviously you can lock, you've got a lock file which will lock you in on a certain version so that somebody else could take your project and then replicate it. Install packages with Rye add, which is like pip install, it does the same functionality. Virtual environment manager, Rye does this for you, so behind the scenes it's already doing that. So it's isolating your project. App runner, so you can define custom entry points, which is kind of what I just showed you with where I was using main and then greet, which was the function. So yeah, this is a very whistle stop overview, but I just think it's now's a good time to kind of bring it to your attention if you've not already seen it. I think it's got a lot of potential, and it just would be nice if everybody who wrote Python had kind of a standard format that they could structure their projects with and just distribute stuff with the same kind of versions and everything. So I haven't used Python for a while, partly because I have been using Rust, and I know there's kind of some friction against Rust, but to be honest, you don't need to know what it's written in. And although this is written in Rust, it makes no difference whether it's written in Rust, C, whatever, because it's given you that functionality. And you can compile it if you want to use Cargo, but you don't have to because you've got Windows, you've got the installer for Windows, and you can do it with a bash script in Mac OS X and Linux. So the commands, they're all here, the documentation's here. I'm not going to kind of just regurgitate that because that's quite pointless, but you've got installation basics, configuration. Obviously, there's some custom configuration shims, which I've yet to kind of really get to the bottom of. But so to start with, Rye init, and then your project's name. You get this standard structure. And then obviously, I added my main.py into that directory. Just make this a bit bigger. The init command accepts lots of options. Say the help is really good on this. You do have to do something called sync to get the first synchronization. Rye manages your virtual env and it activates it for you. To add dependencies, there Rye add flask, and then Rye remove flask. And then really the commands you need to really just use are just sync once you make a change in your pyproject.toml, And then, yeah, there's some other commands here. Show installed dependencies. A lot of these are optional, so don't get overwhelmed by these. Really, if you just want to practice and try it out, then stick to the standard installation and edit the pyproject.toml file, which is in kind of the top level above the source folder. And then obviously inside the source folder, you've got, my project was called R1, Rye1. So you have your top level, and then you get this inside it, then SRC, and then you get your project name there again. So really the best way is just to try it out and the best way is just to experiment and see where you go. All of these commands you can try out: build, config, fetch, format. The format and the linter are really good. So if I do, I think I can run it from here. Let's reformat my file. Is it lint? Yeah. And there's nothing wrong in my file, so it's not actually done anything, changed anything. But show the current state. So it's all lots of very basic commands. You can see it's built me a virtual environment there. It's using Python 3.12 as the default, C Python 3.12.1. So try it out. And I think the project has got lots of contributors. It's being updated. I just see it was updated 5 hours ago. So I think it's been developed quite intensively. And who knows, it might become the de facto standard for Python. Who knows? But yeah. I'm not saying do use it. I'm not saying don't use it. I'm just kind of putting it out there. So hopefully you understand where I'm coming from. I know there's a lot of sort of vested interests and people have been doing certain things certain ways for a long time. So I'm not here to tread on any toes. But by the same token, don't read somewhere that it's built with Rust and then get all defensive about that. It works and it's fast and it's got a great linter and try it, especially if you're new to Python. A lot of the kind of the configuration stuff is just a bit annoying, and it's just more stuff that you got to learn. So I think this does a lot of the heavy lifting for you. So yeah, good. Thanks for watching, and thumbs up, notifications, subscribe, and all the usual stuff that all the YouTube people say. Thank you. Catch you soon.